objective of our study was to quantify the impact of a particular technological change in tropical tuna purse-seine fisheries on fishery, the catch in the fishery. So basically, for many decades, tropical tuna purse-seine fisheries that are active worldwide and catch millions of tunas every year have deployed what are known as fish aggregating devices, basically objects, artificial objects that they put in the water around which tunas aggregate that facilitate catching fish, make it easier to catch fish. What has changed in the last decade is that they have buoys attached to these objects, GPS buoys that allow them to track them and find them. And now these buoys include echosounders. So over the last decade, they have access to this echosounder data, which gives them a rough estimate of the amount of fish below an object, allowing them to remotely determine where are the good places to fish and how much fish they're likely to catch. So this has major implications for the fishing effort and their capacity to catch fish, which ultimately have implications for the sustainability of tuna fisheries, estimates of tuna catch, et cetera. And so our study was, our goal was to estimate what is the impact of having this echosounder data on catch per fishing set. And what we found was that it has a major impact. It has about a 10%, it creates basically a 10% increase in catch per fishing set when they have this echosounder information. And that represents between 2 and 2.5 tons of extra tuna each fishing set. So this is a very important increase in the catch just from one seemingly minor change in the technology used to fish. And this has major implications for how much fish they catch, how we interpret trends in catch, and what impact purse-seine fishers are having on tropical tunas and pelagic ecosystems. The basic innovation that made this paper possible was that for the first time, we have data that permits us to determine for each fishing set whether or not they were fishing on an object for which they have echosounder data. So basically, for a long time, my lab has collected fish logbook data, so where and when they fish. For about a decade and a half, we've had data on the trajectory of the buoys that are attached to these floating objects. And then the last 10 years, we've had data on the echosounder information coming out of these buoys. We were able to put this information together for the first time and determine for each fishing set whether or not they're fishing on one of their own objects for which they have echosounder data, or some other object. It could be a natural object such as a log floating in the ocean, or more likely it's a FAD deployed by another boat for which they don't have access to the echosounder information. So we're able to split apart those two different types of sets, fishing sets on objects for which they have echosounder data and fishing sets on objects for which they don't. And this allowed us to estimate for the first time the impact, the increase in catch due to having echosounder data. Tropical tuna purse-seine fisheries are some of the largest fisheries worldwide. They catch millions of tons every year, and so it's really, really important to manage them correctly. And that involves understanding population trends. Are we overfishing tuna stocks, and are we having a detrimental effect on the sustainability of these fisheries? So in order to do that, we need some index of the population abundance, the size of fish stocks. And unfortunately, because tuna fisheries are so large, over such a large scale, we don't have surveys. We can't go out and just count the number of fish. So what we use is we use fishery data. We use catch data to determine whether or not the population is going up or down. And so we use purse-seine data as one of the indices to do that. The thing is, if you have a technological change that makes it easier to fish, you can't really compare the old catches with the new catches. And in particular, that can hide a trend, for example, a negative trend in the population can be hidden by the fact that technology has made it easier for you to catch fish. So it's really, really important to understand the effects of things like technology on fish catch. And in particular, for the purse-seine fishery, the big question was whether or not echosounders were making it easier to catch and leading them to catch more fish. And our study has shown that this is the case, and therefore we need to take it into account when we look at stock size. So there's two big lessons that come out of this study. One is that you really need to have all of this nexus of information available in order to estimate how technology is affecting catch in purslane fisheries. In particular, you need logbook data. You also need the trajectories of these objects and information about what type of objects are being used and fished upon. And so we, fortunately, and the French fleet have access to that information. That's not always the case, either worldwide or in all fleets fishing in a given ocean. And so it's really, really important that this data be made available. And we're working at the level of International Tuna Regional Fisheries Management Organization to increase access to this data so that scientists from all fleets or scientists from worldwide can look at the data and understand what the impacts are of purslane fisheries. The second major implication here is that we have identified that the use of these echosounders really increases catch per set in an important way that needs to be taken into account when we're estimating stock size. Now, our study focused on catch per set, which is one impact, and we showed that it's large and significant. There's also hints that echosounders increase the ability of fishers to find schools. So it's facilitating finding large fishing schools. So that's two major impacts of echosounders on fish catch that need to be taken into account when estimating, when using catch data to understand trends in tuna populations.